quote by Edward Snowden sums up privacy perfectly. Arguing that you don't care about the right to privacy because you have nothing to hide is no different than saying you don't care about free speech because you have nothing to say. There is a prominent media narrative that suggests anyone who wants privacy must be a criminal. In our current society, this couldn't be further from the truth. Privacy protects us from becoming an overly marketed target of big business and a victim to organized crime. Being careful with our data and implementing good privacy enforcement can protect us from multiple theft scenarios. Privacy is yet another one of those elements of cryptocurrencies that is all too often dismissed as being unimportant. This is normally for one of two reasons. One, it's too difficult to implement without a consensus vote, e.g. a hard fork upgrade, or two, because it doesn't benefit the short-term values of the project. A common fear here is that if an exchange or money manager can't guarantee that the coins haven't come from criminal activity, they could be prosecuted under the latest regulations or guidelines for money laundering. Bitcoin is a pseudo-anonymous cryptocurrency. It's not private. By viewing the Block Explorer, it's possible to track any account or address back to its roots and see the current and previous balances. It's even possible to identify if a user has multiple accounts by the frequency that they transact with other accounts. With a little more investigation and KYC information from exchanges, the true identity of the address owner would soon be uncovered. Good privacy obscures these transactions from being traced, making it harder to find the actual owner of the coins and their transaction and balance history. Without privacy, the coin supply will be divided into clean and dirty coins. Exchanges and merchants will not accept dirty coins and could even go as far as confiscating coins during the transaction process. Systems and lists have already been implemented by some crypto businesses to help blacklist coins that have been used for illegal activity. Some have even gone as far as blacklisting coins that have been involved in coin mixing. All coins should be treated equally. If they're not, the only direction for a project is to become fully custodian and centralized. A custodian will hold all of the clean coins and keep a record of which coins belong to each user. The system looks very similar to the banking system we already have. One of the main areas of concern with some privacy systems is the obfuscation of the coin supply, to the point it's no longer clear if the coin supply is correct. Being able to audit the chain supply is important to make sure the chain is on target to reach its maximum supply and to make sure that the supply hasn't been deliberately inflated. Decred's privacy design is based on the principle of coin mixing. The implementation is called Coin Shuffle +++. This is where a user's coins enter into a pool, and when they return, the inputs and outputs for each coin have been fully anonymized, which obfuscates the ownership of the coin. The process is completed without the need for a custodian to take possession of the coins. There are generally two concerns with the coin mixing process. One, most projects don't have a big enough pool size to completely obfuscate coin ownership. And two, it can be quite expensive and time consuming to complete the transaction. Decred solves the first of these issues by utilizing Decred's ticket pool to make sure there is always a large enough number of coins to participate. Decred's ticket pool processes thousands of DCR coins each and every day, so by combining it with the privacy, removes the need for a third-party service and the additional layer of risk. As for the expense issue, this gets greatly reduced on the Decred chain purely because there is no third party needed to process these transactions. That being said, mixing your coins is still slightly more expensive than a normal transaction. For instance, a standard transaction will cost approximately 4,000 atoms, currently a fraction of a penny, and a mixed transaction will cost approximately 30,000 atoms, which is currently about 3 pence. As a comparison to this mixing reference, Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash mixing services would typically charge between 0.5 and 3% in fees. For example, 300 coins mixed would cost between 1.5 BTC and 9 BTC in fees. As an additional consideration, these services are offered by third parties, not by the project. Coin mixing, or coin join as it's sometimes referred to, is seen as one of the easiest implementations of privacy, and the fact that it's optional and doesn't obfuscate the coin supply makes it a very desirable feature. There are two other types of privacy in the cryptocurrency space that are worth a mention, and they are ZK-SNARKs that are implemented on the Zcash network and ring signatures that are implemented on the Monero network. Both have some pretty impressive technology behind them with the possibilities of moving privacy to the next level as might be needed in the future. The majority of us will not need privacy until it's gone. In the digital world, privacy and our right to it is becoming increasingly important to protect. With central banks talking about central bank digital currencies and regulators demanding all crypto services keep information on their customers, privacy is slowly but surely being stripped away. The interesting thing about regulations and KYC is that they can only be implemented on custodian services. These are services that hold and control your coins. So for instance, projects like Decred, who are busy building non-custodian services and becoming more decentralized over time, privacy becomes easier and more realistic to maintain.